Hi guys, my name's Az and welcome back to the GTR Heritage Centre's YouTube channel. Now, a few weeks ago I did a video on the R33 GTR market, and on that video we were speaking about a R33 GTR UK V-Spec, and in that video I said that it was going to be booked in for our restoration service. I also hinted towards that it was getting an acid dip. Now in this week's video, Dave will be taking you through that process and why this is the only way to do a restoration properly. Over to Dave.
Thanks very much, Az, for the intro. So restoration moved on to the next level is what I'm going to talk about now. This is a process, something we just introduced very recently, where we've decided to move on from just removing the paint on the outside of the car to removing the paint from the inside of the car, and also doing a penetrative dip in an acid tank. So it's not an easy process, it's very labor intensive, but we feel when people are talking about restorations and you see the word bandied around everywhere on social forums, Instagram, and a lot of these restorations are purely a fancy paint job, and there's a lot of body filler goes in, there's a lot of rust hidden, and everything to go with it. And we've seen plenty of examples of these cars coming to us to have rectification work done. So the car I've got behind me, this is quite a rare car. It's a 1974 Nissan Skyline C10 four-door. So this belongs to an avid follower of ours, a doctor from London, who's been following us on social media for years, reached out, contacted us, told us about his childhood. He can remember as a young boy going out with his father in an amazing car, and he wants now to kind of bring that history back to life. That's for another video by itself, and we'll talk you through that project. But what we decided to do with this particular car is this acid dip, so we call this our Le Mans Plus, for want of a better description. So the process involves us receiving the car, totally stripping the car of absolutely every single thing in it. Wiring, soundproofing, panels, everything you can imagine. Once that shell is then stripped entirely, we then ship it off to a specialist company. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks where the vehicle goes to them. It goes onto a jig, it goes into an acid tank, it's revolved multiple times, left for a few weeks immersed, it comes out, the drill holes in it everywhere, they tip it upside down, drain out the fluid, and then goes back into another tank for something called an E-coat. Well, this product's manufactured by this week's sponsor, which is PPG Paint Refinishing. Global business, top three paint manufacturing, coating manufacturer in the world. And we just want to say thank you very much for sponsoring us and being part of this exciting process. Back to the car now, and then with this particular one, as you can see, I'll walk you around it and I'll point to a few areas. The process we're discussing removes every element of corrosion from inside the car, because quite often when we're working on vehicles, well, we can only repair what we see, we can only paint what we see. And what we're starting to find now with a lot of these older cars is there are hidden areas that it's physically impossible to get an air tool into, to get a hand into, to get a brush into. And a lot of these become problematic years on when the corrosion which is trapped inside just works its way through the steel. It's the course of nature, and it's impossible to stop unless you consider doing this process. So as I say, it takes 4 to 5 weeks for it to do. We strip the car down, we ship the car off in our covered trailer, goes into an acid bath for a couple of weeks, which is rotated, comes out, gets dried, the drill holes in to drain the fluid. Then it goes back in, and then it gets an E-coat. So if I stand back, you can see that this car is a very dull black, but this car has been entirely stripped of all corrosion. The acid which they use eats into the corrosion, takes it out completely. And if we walk around the car, you can see where it's had previous repairs which have been hidden. The small areas down here where it's had some corrosion work before. It shows that this car's fairly original. It's got very good structure to it. You can see the inside of the vehicle now where, again, all of the existing factory paintwork's been stripped, and you can actually see what this E-coat is that we're referring to. Lovely clean floor pan. It's exactly the same underneath as well. So we've got a very good structure to work with. when we do this acid dip, it will reveal any areas that need repairing. General rule of thumb is if you're left with a spider's web, you've got good steel to work with. If you're left with a big gaping hole, then obviously the fabricators have to do the bit and make a panel to go inside of it. So you can see just how far we go when we actually strip the vehicle. So no engine, this is DW powered one, so it's probably going to be better than the original. But you can kind of see exactly where you benefit from going down this full dip process, because as you can imagine, as a human being with a hand tool, trying to get into all these little nicks and little curves and everything, well, it's physically impossible. There's no way to get away from it. But if you use this acid dip process, it's taken care of by good nature. Everything goes in, everything comes out, and what we're left with is a solid shell like this. So, taking you to the back of the car, it's exactly the same process. Once again, trying to have a human hand get into all these reveal panels and then these little nooks and creases, it's physically impossible. But if we go ahead and do a dip, then we can, as I keep on saying, remove every ounce of rust from your vehicle and then give it an E-coat. And the E-coat helps us reinforce our 10-year warranty. If you need any more details on this process, you know what to do. Give us a ring or just hit any of the little links below. Speak to the guys on the front desk. You might speak to us, who you've met before. You might speak to John, or you might get through to me. So just want to sign up from this little video and say thank you very much for watching. It's an absolute pleasure. The amount of feedback that we're getting now off our social media site, YouTube channel, is phenomenal. Please keep the questions coming. If you've got questions about the dipping process, drop a comment below the video and we'll get back to you straight away. Thank you very much and just have a great time. Bye-bye.